gorgeous.
How's the day been so far? How's Comic-Con been for you?
It's great. I mean, we went to like one interview, which was like on a yacht. The other was like on a rooftop with like a nice spread. I'm like, this is great. I can do this. Aw, no, it's good. I really like this. I like just getting to like sit and chat.
You just came back from France. You've just been all over.
I did. We did like a whole European little trip. Matt Morrison, Darren Criss were there. It was so nice. This was our first hiatus since, oh gosh, we started shooting Glee in 2008, and we've literally been working consistently, only having breaks for like the Christmas holidays and like small bits of time after our tours. So this is like, I like wake up in the morning now and I'm like, I don't know what to do, but it's great. It's so great. I got to spend a lot of time in New York with my family. So like did the family time. I was in LA. I got settled in my new house. I did a little European trip, and now I'm like, okay, ready to go. Ready to go back to work.
So what can we expect from Rachel in New York?
Oh my goodness. Well, she's, you know, going to be sort of alone when we first see her, starting in a new school in a new city. And I think it's going to be really interesting sort of seeing her in this place. You know, she's always been surrounded by her friends in an environment that she knows, and now she's by herself with people she doesn't know in a school full of 800 other Rachel Berrys. So I think that that's going to be challenging for her, but I think that she always works best when she has to sort of fight her way to the top.
Do you think she's going to revert a little bit more back to season one Rachel, who was a little neurotic, really annoying, like, look at me, notice me, here's my gold star?
I definitely think that, you know, that's sort of her, what she does when she feels like she needs to get somewhere. It's like, I'm going to put my determination hat on. You know, and obviously when her and Finn got together, you sort of saw her kind of mellow out a little bit and feel like she wanted to, you know, take sort of a step back. But I think that season one Rachel Berry makes a lot of sense for, you know, starting a yacht.
Lea, I asked Corey about this.
Mm-hmm.
The scene between the two of you.
Yeah.
Where you broke up when he told you to go.
Yeah.
And dream. He said that that was one of his favorite scenes that he has shot on the show so far.
Uh-huh.
My question was to him, and I'm going to ask you the same thing. So emotional. You had to cry. Girl, you had to cry so hard.
Yeah.
How did you keep doing that, take after take, shot after shot, going down inside? Mm-hmm. What were you thinking about?
Oh, I'm a crier. You want to cry right now? We'll cry. We'll cry all day. We'll cry all day, all night. Let's listen to some sad music. Cry. I love it. I love it.
So
it's
if they
great.
Say to
oh,
you,
I was ready
cry,
to
Lea.
Cry. Like, I cried all day, and it was amazing. It was so great.
Cathartic?
It was cathartic. It was incredible. I listened to, like, sad music. I didn't stop. I literally did not stop crying. And then when it was over, I was like, okay, great. Done. And I was like, it was great.
You've pretty much gone through Barbara's complete catalog.
Not yet.
No. Is there one left you are waiting to do?
Well, I know I'm doing one in episode one. It's Barbara covering a popular song, I'll tell you that. But as far as Barbara's songs are concerned, I really do feel like I've done my faves. I've sort of started now bugging Ryan with Celine.
Yes.
Celine songs.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys.